Another witness implicates former President Rodrigo Duterte in the 2016 killing of three Chinese drug lords in a Davao prison. During Thursday's hearing of the House Quad Committee on the Duterte administration's drug war, former Davao prison warden Gerardo Padilla confirmed the testimony of hitman Leopoldo Tan. He said Duterte indeed congratulated him for the murder of the three Chinese. He said he received information about the operation from former police officer Royina Garma, who allegedly had close relationship with the former president. Garma denied the claims, leading to the lawmakers citing her in contempt.
Pinapatutuhanan ko ang sinabi ni Tata na nung papunta kami sa investigation section, ay tumunog ang cellphone ko at ito ay sinagot ko. Ang tumawag sa akin ay, ayon sa boses, ay dating President Rodrigo Roa Duterte. At sinabing congrats, Superintendent Padilla. Job well done, pero grabe yung ginugahan.
You know, he lied on the first hearing. The second hearing, because he was detained, might be he realized that sa kanya lahat ang siyang may kasalanan. He need a fall guy.
Former presidential spokesperson Harry Roque also again ordered arrested by the Quadcom for failing to submit documents that will prove he has no links to POGOs. Roque now planning to question the order before the Supreme Court.
Na ang nangyayari dito sa Quadcom ay hindi investigasyon. Ito isang witch hunt. Ito isang kangaroo court. Mula nang binuo nila ito, ang kanilang pakay lang ay sirain ng mga Duterte at ang kanilang mga aliado. Ang iniimbestigahan dito, POGO. Ano naman ang kinalaman ng mga personal records sa POGO na yan?
Philippine police bear more details of the alleged sexual abuse committed by arrested televangelist Apollo Quiboloy on underaged members of his religious sect. But his lawyers are dismissing what they say are fabricated testimonies of the alleged victims. Ryan Capulong reports.
Ang kaso po na ito ay medyo sensitibo po.
Horrible. This is how spokesperson Police Colonel Gene Fajardo of the Philippine National Police described the stories shared by the minor victims who were allegedly sexually abused by Kingdom of Jesus Christ Pastor Apollo Quiboloy. According to Fajardo, the victims recounted how they were repeatedly molested by the pastor, who assured them that their virginity remains intact. The victims' testimonies also include Quiboloy's promise that they would go to heaven.
So just can imagine a minor being sexually molested by an individual at sinasabi po nila na as early as 12 or 13 years old they were allegedly sexually molested by Apollo Quiboloy. Well, ang isang sinasabi is Diyos ang kanilang pinagsisilbihan at kung ano man yung gagawin nila ay yun yung parang kanilang passes to heaven.
Fardo also revealed that the victims and their families would be pursued by the so-called angels of death if they violated the group's code of secrecy. The PNP is trying to identify the supposed angels of death in Quiboloy's group.
Well, hindi natin alam kung ito bang angels of death ay literally mga sinasabing mga goons nila Quiboloy or just a figurative speech na sinasabi para takutin ang mga bata. So kasama po yan sa ginagawa po nating investigasyon.
The PNP also investigate the parents of the victims who are allegedly members of KOJC and aware of the abuse being committed to their children. The PNP is calling on other victims of Quiboloy to come forward and report to the authorities, assuring them of government protection.
Ang lumalabas na alam di umano ng mga magulang dahil nga parang they are being offered. Asahan niya, sir, na hindi tayo titigil hanggang makuha ng mga batang ito ang hustisyang para sa kanila.
But Quiboloy's camp brushes off the allegations.
Kung may mga bago, I'm sure planted yung lahat yun, mga manufactured yan. But let them prove their case kasi the accused is presumed innocent. Allegation is not equivalent to guilt.
Meantime, the Bureau of Jail Management and Penology gave its assurance Ricky Buloy will not receive any special treatment in their facility.
Kung saan po nabigyan ng utos ng korte na dalhin ang isang nakakulong o kahit sino mang tao, eh wala po kaming magagawa kundi yun na po talaga, ikulong siya doon at kung ano ang meron doon sa seldang yun o kulungang yun. Sa tinitiyak po namin sa part ng BJMP, walang VIP treatment at kahit sino man po yan ay pantay-pantay at initinatrato nating ordinaryong PDL.
The PNP confirmed that Kibuloy and the other co-accused will attend the face-to-face arraignment at the Regional Trial Court in Pasig City Friday morning. This is related to their case of qualified human trafficking, which has no bail. Raya Kapulong, ABS-CBN News.
The Philippine Justice Secretary plans to revive murder charges against ex-Palawan Governor Joel Reyes, who surrendered to authorities Wednesday. Reyes had been accused of plotting the 2011 murder of broadcaster and environmentalist Jerry Ortega. Reyes had been criticized by Ortega over mining operations in Palawan. The murder case against Reyes was archived in Puerto Princesa for years before the Supreme Court transferred it to a Quezon City Regional Trial Court.
It's an old case already, but of course, we're talking about the murder of an environmentalist. Ang pinatay dito, yung talagang dumidepensa sa kalikasan. Kaya hindi natin nililimutan na mahalaga ang kasong to para naman maging tahimik sa ating mga kalooban na hindi ito pinababayaan ng gobyerno.
Ortega's widow thanked Remulla and the National Bureau of Investigation for aiding in the arrest of Reyes. But she is dissatisfied with the slow pace of justice for her husband's murder.
I cannot say if I still have faith. It's slowly diminishing as time goes by. Because we have already all the evidences and his right-hand person is already convicted and is serving sentence. And the Supreme Court gives him leeway to change the court from Puerto Princesa to Quezon City. So I don't know what to expect really. I just give up to our God.
A Philippine congressional panel offers a drastic cut in the proposed 2025 budget of the Office of Vice President Sara Duterte. The House Appropriations Committee wants it reduced to 733 million from the original proposal of 2 billion pesos. The committee's senior vice chairperson, Stella Kimbo, says the amount slashed from the vice president's budget can be realigned to health and social welfare programs. The vice president's budget sponsor, Zia Alonto Adyong, accepts the proposed reduction as fair and reasonable. Adyong says he has yet to discuss it with Vice President Duterte.
It's fair and reasonable. If we go back to the basics, right, if you want to really make the office of the vice president operate according to its mandate, the realignment of these funds is not a breach of, for example, a violation or breach of the mandate of the Office of the President to make it operational.
The proposed budget cut for Vice President Duterte follows her feud with House lawmakers who insisted on scrutinizing her previous expenditures as Education Secretary. Turning now to the West Philippine Sea issue, heightened tensions in Squatter Shoal trigger fresh talks between the Philippines and China. But no one appears to be conceding. Beijing is still ordering Manila to immediately withdraw the BRP Teresa Magbanua, the Philippine Coast Guard's lone vessel at the Squatter Shoal. But Manila has no plans to remove the vessel, despite the damage it sustained from last month's ramming incident with the Chinese Coast Guard. In the last 7 days, over 200 Chinese vessels were monitored inside Philippine waters, and almost 70 of these have surrounded the Teresa Magbanua.
Binabantayan natin yung mga possible reclamation activities. There, Teresa Magbanua is there for maritime patrol. It's also doing work on marine preservation and monitoring fisheries in that area. So these are all acts of a sovereign country. So we are committed to keep it there.
Let's get an update on the weather now from Pagasa forecaster Anna Clauden-Horta. Good morning, Anna.
Yes, good morning, Bettina. Here's the update to the severe tropical storm Bebinca, who is now located at around 1,605 kilometers east of extreme northern Luzon. This severe tropical storm may enter our area of responsibility this afternoon or this evening and will remain offshore. Meanwhile, the southwest monsoon that is being enhanced by this severe tropical storm is now affecting southern Luzon, Visayas, and Mindanao. And today, this southwest monsoon or habagat will bring heavy to intense rains over Mimaropa area, western Visayas, Sorsogon, Masbate, and Negros Occidental. Moderate to heavy rains are expected in over Batangas, Quezon, the rest of Bicol region, and the rest of Visayas. Here in Metro Manila and the rest of the country, we're expecting a generally mostly cloudy skies with scattered rains and thunderstorms due to the southwest monsoon and to the trough of severe tropical storm Bebinca. And for our weather forecast tomorrow, the rains over the Mimaropa area, western Visayas, Negros Island region will continue over the weekend. And here in Metro Manila, we're expecting a moderate to heavy rains by tomorrow. That's why we advise the public to continue monitoring for the updates released by PAGASA. And the next update will be at around 11 a.m. today. And that's the latest from PAGASA. This is Anna Clauden-Horta. Good morning.
Thank you very much for that update, Anna. And as we reported, the self-proclaimed Son of God, Apollo Kibuloy, and his cohorts are set to be arraigned this morning at the Regional Trial Court in Pasig City. This is related to their case of qualified human trafficking, which has no bail. Now, our correspondent, Karen De Guzman, joins us on the line for more. Go ahead, Karen.
Bettina, strict security has been put in place at the Pasig Regional Trial Court, where it is expected that Kingdom of Jesus Christ founder and leader Pastor Apollo Kibuloy, along with his co-accused, will physically appear for their arraignment. This is in relation to their case of qualified human trafficking at the RTC Branch 159 under George Reynelda Estacio Montesa. A security convoy will escort Kibuloy from PNP Camp Krame to Pasig. The PNP previously stated that they would be on alert for the possible influx of Kibuloy supporters. Police officers are stationed around RTC, working alongside other agencies to ensure security. The arraignment in Pasig is set for 8 in the morning, while a video conference for their case at the Quezon City Regional Trial Court will take place at 1 in the afternoon. Right now, Bettina, we are actually climbing up the stairs and will be at the 5th floor lobby where the arraignment will be happening later. We're also waiting for the convoy that will bring Pastor Apollo Kibuloy together with his cohorts here at the Regional Trial Court. Bettina.
All right. Thank you so much for that update, Karen. We'll get more information from you later in the newscasts now.